Ooh, look at the birds.
Informant is real.
Yes.
We have the name of their next target.
The name is Neo.
We'll need a search running.
It has already begun.
Is it?
Ronnie.
Oh, hi, man.
Hey, man. Want to go get something to eat tonight?
Yeah, sure. Dude, where you want to go eat?
I don't even know, man. Where do you want to go?
Yeah, let's just go across the street.
All right, sounds good.
Sorry, Neo. I had to make sure you weren't followed. Please, sit down. Who are you? My name is Trinity.
Trinity? The Trinity?
Who took on the largest meatpacking industry in the United States single-handedly? Well, this is a small world. Well, glad to see you know something, but that was a long time ago.
Jesus,
Those were your texts. Do you make a habit of prying into the lives of others?
Look, never mind that. All that is important right now is that you are in real danger. I brought you here to warn you.
Well, what about...
They're watching you, Neo.
Who is?
Please, just listen. I know why you're here. You're looking for answers, just as I did. If you look hard enough, and you let them, the answers will find you.
What is the Matrix?
The answer's out there, Neo. It's looking for you, and it will find you, if you allow it. Yeah.
You need to come with me, please. We have some questions we need to ask you.
What for?
I'm afraid that's confidential, but you have to come with us, one way or another. As you can see, we've had our eye on you for quite some time, Mr. Anderson. Now, recently you've said some things that those I represent found rather off-putting. Now, you go by an alias of Neo. Nevertheless, it's the name of the same person who is guilty of every food libel crime we have a law for. I'm going to be as forthcoming as I can, Mr. Anderson. You're here because we need your help. Now, we know you've been contacted by a certain individual, a man who goes by the name of Morpheus. Now, whatever you may think you know about him is irrelevant. He is considered by our authorities to be perhaps the most dangerous man alive. My colleagues believe that I am wasting my time with you, but I believe that you want to do the right thing. We're willing to wipe the slate clean, give you a fresh start. And all we ask for in return is your cooperation in bringing a known terror to justice.
Yeah, wow, that sounds like a really great idea, but I got a better one. Why don't I give you the finger, and I get my phone call?
You disappoint me, Mr. Anderson.
Great card.
Whether you want to or not.
Stop! Stop! No! Wait!
This line is tapped, so I must be brief. They got to you first, but they underestimated how important you are.
What's this about?
I'll explain later, but right now I need to know if you still want to meet.
Yes.
Then go to the Samuel Street Bridge.
This is it. He's waiting for you inside.
At last. Welcome, Neo. As you no doubt have guessed, I am Morpheus. I imagine you are feeling a bit like Alice, tumbling headfirst into the rabbit hole.
You could say that.
I can see it in your eyes. You have the look of a man who accepts what he eats because he believes he has no other choice. However, this is not the truth.
Do you believe in fate, Neo?
No.
Why not?
Because I don't like the idea
that I'm not in control of my life.
I know exactly what you mean. Let me explain why you're here. You're here because you know something. But you know you can't explain. But you feel it. You felt it your entire life. That there is something wrong with the food you eat. You don't know what it is, but it's there. Like a splinter in your mind, driving you mad. It is this feeling that has brought you to me. Do you know what I'm talking about?
The Matrix?
Do you want to know what it is? The Matrix is everywhere. It is all around us. Even in this very room. You can see it when you look down at your plate or when you watch television. You can feel it when you go to work. When you go to lunch, when you pay your taxes. It is the world that has been pulled over your eyes to blind you from the truth.
What truth?
That you are a slave, Neo. Like everyone around you, you were lured into bondage, lured into a prison of smell and touch, a prison for your tastes. Unfortunately, nobody can be told what the Matrix is. You have to see it for yourself. This is your last chance. After this, there is no turning back. You take the yellow pill. The story ends. You wake up in your bed, and you believe whatever you want to believe. You take the red pill. You stay in Wonderland, and I show you just how deep the rabbit hole goes. Remember, all I'm offering is the truth. Follow me. Let me introduce you to some of the others who have escaped the grasp of the Matrix. You already know Trinity. This is Switch.
Yo.
Cypher. And Tank, our operator. You wanted to know what the Matrix is? Come with me.
Morpheus, where are we?
We call this the Construct. It is where they base their operations. Hungry?
No, not really.
Just as well. Most of it is not real anyways.
Wait, what are you talking about? What are you playing me for? You're saying that none of this, the Oreos, the Chips Ahoy, the fruits, the candies, the meats, none of it with their luscious, mouth-watering aromas, none of it is real?
What is real? How do you define real? If you're talking about what you can feel, what you can smell, what you can taste and see, then real is simply what your senses perceive. That would be an agent. Let's get out of here.
Deal, Mr. Reagan.
You know, I know this chicken isn't real. I know that when I put it into my mouth, my brain is telling me that it's juicy and delicious. And after 9 years, you know what I realize? Ignorance is bliss.
And then we have a deal.
I don't want to remember nothing. Nothing. You understand? And I want to be rich.
Whatever you want, Mr. Reagan.
Okay, I get them where you want, you nab them, and you'll get what you want.
Files on the organization.
No, I told you, I don't have them. But I can get you the man who does.
Morpheus.
This is the meat industry as you know it. The industry as it existed in the middle of the last century. It exists now only as a veil to the modern meatpacking industry, what we call the Meatrix. You've been living in a dream world, Neo. This is our food as it exists today. The meat that modern animals generate contains over twice the caloric energy the same animals contained 20 years ago because of the increased fat content. Humans have engineered them, perfected them in their capacity for secondary productivity. There are fields, endless fields, where animals, if you can still call them such, wallow. They are grown. For the longest time, I wouldn't believe it. Then I saw the fields with my own eyes. Efficiency. The Meatrix is an industrial compound built to keep us out, animals in, and to turn subsidized corn into this. Nearly all of our food is industrial. It is made in extensive feedlots. Even the chicken in that sub is probably made of it.
Now, I'm afraid you're severely mistaken. You see, that's impossible.
Are you sure? Take another look.
Ah!
You see, everything is derived from corn. It is the foundation of the system. Since the middle of the 20th century, it has established a stranglehold on most of the food industry, including the meat industry. Because corn is foreign to most of these animals' diets, we began shaping cows to consume corn as a food source. This unnatural relation inevitably led to a multitude of problems, such as new strains of intestinal bacteria in cows, which now require injections of powerful antibiotics to kill. At the turn of the century, it was found that 50% of steer at feedlots contained one such bacteria, the newest E. coli strain, E. coli 0157H7. We are essentially leading ourselves closer and closer to our own destruction by antibiotic immune superstrains. Chicken has also seen a rise in the number of diseases found within their meat. Conservative estimates put the number of chickens with salmonella around 7%, and the number with Campylobacter around 30%. It is believed this problem will continue to be amplified, since these diseases are transferred to subsequent generations through eggs contaminated with fecal matter. In the production of eggs by chickens, Salmonella enteritidis is a major problem because of the massive crowding of chickens in industrial storehouses, where the eggs are passed through fecal matter. There is another, more ambiguous method that scientists do not fully understand. But through either method, the disease is passed to the egg by the hen. And this poses another problem of food contamination. Each day, a feedlot steer produces 50 pounds of manure, which remains trampled below hundreds of feet and is spread throughout the lot. During processing of steers, their hides are sometimes poorly cleaned, allowing fecal matter and dirt to accompany the meat into processing. Or sometimes during the removal of organs, parts of the animal's digestive tract and the waste it contains may also accompany the steer's carcass into the grinder. Despite these problems, however, industrialized meat now costs half the price it did in the 1970s, at least superficially. The meat industries are now quite powerful and fight to ensure their survival by removing any who question or criticize their product or conduct, no matter how truthful that criticism may be. It is because of this that...
What he's doing.
I don't give a shit.
Get out of my way.
Get out of my way, boy.
What's your problem?
You're my problem. You're my problem, smartass. You should have thought through him, man.
Neo.
Yeah.
Remember, Neo, you must believe in the power of the consumer. It is the only way to beat the Meatrix.
Wait, Morpheus, what are you doing?
I'm going to give you the chance you need to get out. When I do, get out.
Wait, Morpheus. Morpheus, wait. Morpheus. Morpheus. I don't want to be alone anymore.
Great Morpheus, we meet at last.
And you are?
A Smith. Agent Smith.
You all look the same to me.
Morpheus, no!
Operator.
I need to get out of here, quick!
Cipher?
Where are you?
I'm at the intersection of Tamarack and Pine.
Tank, it's me.
It's Morpheus alive.
It's Morpheus alive, Tank.
Yeah, but he's on the move, and I'm not sure of his exact location.
Morpheus is alive. Tank, we need to get out of here.
The old warehouse district. That's right near Cypher.
Cypher?
Yeah, hurry up. I'm at the intersection of Tamarack and Pine.
Got it.
Where are they?
They'll be here soon.
Good.
What are you doing?
Where's Neo?
It's right behind us.
I'll wait for him. You go. Come on, Neo.
Cypher?
Hello, Trinity.
Cypher? Where's Tank?
Did I ever tell you how beautiful it is? All our food stemming from one thing, corn. The pure mechanization is marvelous, and it creates a product that we can all accept. It's cheap, it tastes good, and most of all, it sets us apart from the rest of the world. It's also perfect, though. It's a shame it had to turn to this.
You killed them?
I'm tired of this organic bullshit, Trinity. I just don't care what's in my meat anymore. We're not making any difference anyways. It'll always be the same. We might as well accept it. We're just interfering with the inevitable. There is no hope for the family farm anymore. Morpheus was full of it. That's why they needed to get him.
You gave them Morpheus?
I don't believe it.
Believe it or not, you son of a bitch, you're gonna burn.
Have you ever stood and stared at it? Marveled at the beauty? Billions of people just living out their lives, completely oblivious. You know, the first Meatrix actually incorporated normal, farm-grown animals. Where there was no suffering, they lived rather pleasant, healthy lives. Of course, that became obsolete. You could never have afforded as much meat back then as you can today. Humans as a species have thrived on the consumption of meat. Therefore, it was decided, why not continue to consume this evolutionary product? This is why the Meatrix was redesigned to provide civilization with the product we instinctively crave. The world of meat industry is our world, Morpheus. The future is our time for efficiency.
I'm going back for him.
Why isn't the serum working? Maybe we're asking the wrong questions.
Leave me with him. Now! Can you hear me, Morpheus? I'm going to be honest with you. I hate this place, this zoo, this prison, this industry, whatever you want to call it. I can't stand it anymore. It's the smell. I feel saturated by it. I can taste the stink. And every time I do, I feel I've somehow become infected by it. I need to get out of here. I have to get free. And in this mind is the key. My key. You see, once the resistance is destroyed, I will no longer have to be here. Do you understand? I need the files. I need to get in. You need to tell me how. You are going to tell me how, or you are going to die.
What were you doing? Don't you know?
About what?
I think they're trying to save him.
Real.
It may not be all natural, but the flavor is the same. It tastes better even. There's more deliciousness in each single link.
Yes, it is quite tantalizing to my taste buds.
Give in, Mr. Anderson. It's always been inevitable.
There is no meat here.
What's he doing?
He's beginning to believe.
You're out there. I can feel you now. I know that you're afraid. You're afraid of us. You're afraid of change. I don't know the future. I didn't come here to tell you how this is going to end. I came here to tell you how this is going to begin. Now, I'm going to hang up this phone, and I'm going to show these people what you don't want them to see. I'm going to show them a world without you, a world without doctored food and deceit, without illness and lies. Where we go from there is a choice I leave to you.
Sexy black man voice.
Wait, do you have to push?
Oh dear, yeah.
You've got some nerve coming in here. I do, do I? This is my prized possession.
Well,
God, you're dumb. So high up. 8 feet tall. You're just about 8 feet. I don't want to.
Quite some time. This isn't working.
No, that's perfect. Cypher. Cypher.
Did you know we're being killed? That's what I am.
What?!
No doggy biscuits for you today.
No treats for you.
Morpheus is right over there!
Hey.
Thank you.
Everyone quiet and rolling. So
damn.
That ain't the point.
The meat industries are now quite powerful and fight to ensure that.
God damn it, Moody.
Keep it rolling. He's not in the background, right?
Shut up!
Cashman?
You said you...
Wow!
Look who's up in the mirror!
Tom! Now, it's Dr. Jekyll!
That's awesome.
Hey! You wanna go out for dinner tonight, man?
Alright, bro, I'll go get my stuff. I'll meet you there.
Alright.
Where you wanna eat?
I don't know.
Okay, I'll meet you there anyway. That's alright. See you, dude.
I think... Eric, I'm gonna kill you.
Oh. It's cheap, tastes good, and most of all, it sets us apart from the rest of the world. Hello, Trinity. Did I ever tell you how beautiful it is, all our corn? Hello, Trinity. Did I ever tell you how beautiful it is, all our food, steaming from one thing, corn?
Damn it, Eric.
Go.
What? Are you serious? Really?
Oh, whatever.
I'm gonna leave the fire inside that place.
This is all that's left.
Mr. Anderson!
You dress call! It's coming from inside the house!
I'm sorry?
It's P2, you want to get off on the phone?
Oh, that's fine. I'm just going to hold it up.
Oh. Come on!
Wait, hold on.
And make your mama cry.
It's too late for me.
Go, Charlie, fast as you can. Run home.
I'm just a washed up computer program.
He's helpless. It's horrible. He gave up his hopes and dreams.
And the last word?
It's the smell.
That's it.